County. This is a severe thunderstorm that could well have a tornado associated with it. You can see the red shaded area here on our map in Carroll County shows you where the tornado warning is in effect until 4:30 this afternoon. That puts it in the general area of Westminster. And when we look at our radar, you'll see that there is some very heavy rain coming down there. Lots of lightning associated with this storm as well. Dangerous lightning strikes moving through and the potential for some damaging winds moving right through the central part of Carroll County as we speak. So this is an area of concern. Again, a tornado warning in effect until 4:30 in this area of Carroll County, including the city of Westminster, town of Westminster there. Storm tracking southeast. You can see the general motion by the angle of the warning. So it's moving in this direction over toward the Baltimore County line. Severe thunderstorm warning extends into Baltimore County because the potential for this storm to move in pretty quickly. It's been racing quickly across central Carroll County. And when we look at the wind speed on here, we can see that there's a lot of shear. There's a lot of areas on this map where you can see the red and the green coming together, indicating winds moving away from the radar site and toward the radar site in a very tight little area there, just to the west of Westminster. So this would apparently be where a possible tornado would be right now, just west of Westminster and tracking down to the southeast at a pretty good little clip here. This indication shows hail, but it is a tornadic storm perhaps, and movement is off to the south and east at about 20 miles an hour. Say that again to me, Don. Our cameras there up there near the Pennsylvania line. Perhaps we can detect some hail falling in that storm area there. Don, can you tell me where exactly that camera is? Because I can't see it on my screen. What shot we're Route 30? Yeah, Route 30 there near the Pennsylvania line. That's the picture we see over there just to the north of this storm system. So some very heavy rain, hail associated with it as it's moving east-southeast at about 20 miles an hour out of the Westminster area over toward the Baltimore-Carroll County line. So a warning again until 4:30 for this storm that's in Carroll County tracking southeast at 20. So areas that are going to be impacted would include Westminster itself over toward Hawkesville and along that Route 140 corridor there in the eastern part of Carroll County. So we're watching this very closely. If you in the area of this storm, certainly you want to take the normal tornado precautions, which is get down low, get into the lowest level of your building, away from windows, sturdy building if you can find it. A house that has a basement is the best place to be, interior room or hallways, and away from the windows. Those are our typical tornado safety tips for the storm that we are tracking up in Carroll County. There's the red shaded area there, and it is very close to the Westminster area. Possible storm. If you're in the general vicinity there, the central part of Carroll County, you want to be taking shelter now for that storm that's moving through with lightning, hail, and possibly a tornado associated with it, tracking down to the south and east at 20 miles an hour. So this is the general direction that it's moving like this. And I'm going to zoom in a little closer just so we can get some more areas that are in the path of this storm. Here's the motion over the past couple of minutes, cutting right into Westminster now and tracking east-southeast along 140 over toward the Baltimore County line. Looks like Hampstead's on the north side of it, Smallwood's on the south side, and these areas here just to the east of Westminster, Glover Acres, you want to be taking shelter. Hawkesville, you want to be taking shelter. All these areas in and around Westminster, definitely in the path of a potential tornadic storm. There's the velocity coming out of BWI, sometimes gives us a better indication of where it is. And so there you see, that's the radar from BWI. And so what you see here is winds going toward the radar site and winds going away from the radar site. And the very real distinct possibility that there's either a funnel or a tornado here. This little current update on the radar is showing us some pretty strong winds. So 50 mile an hour winds being detected by the BWI radar, probably aloft, but potentially touching down near the ground there, and some very strong shear. Change in wind direction and speed is wind shear. And when we see that, we know there's likely a funnel there where the wind is, again, changing direction or speed in a very small little area, blowing toward the radar site and away from the radar site. So this does look like this would be the area of prime concern here, just south of Westminster, moving in the general direction of Glover Acres. that little community there. The storm is tracking east-southeast at about 20 miles an hour. So take shelter now. Areas, especially just to the south of Westminster, it looks like that's where the radar is indicating the most likely location for this possible tornadic storm would be, in that area right there. And it's going to take just a few minutes for it to blow by. You want to wait for the sound of the storm to move on through. You want to get into the lowest level of your building, away from windows, and let it pass on by. It looks like it's going to cut south of Westminster, track through Carroll County, and perhaps head over toward the Reisterstown area in western Baltimore County. So at this point, you want to be careful in western Baltimore County right now, from Upper Cota to Reisterstown. This is a tornadic storm that's moving in your direction. And so you definitely want to be taking precautions even now, because it'll get there pretty quick. The distance from where that storm is right now to the Baltimore County line is only about 10 miles or so, 5 to 10 miles. So it's moving 20 miles an hour. It's going to be there in a few minutes on that track over in that direction. Taylor, have you got any more information over there on this storm?
The National Weather Service chat, which kind of issues the tornado warnings. No updates in terms of the actual tornado warning. It's still continuing at this point in time. I do want to bring you a live update, as Tom was saying, exactly where the storm is tracking. It's towards the east, south, and east, and it's moving extremely fast, around 20, 25 miles per hour. So I do want to give you some of the neighborhoods that will be in the track of this storm system as it moves rapidly. Again, Reisterstown, as Tom had just mentioned, by around 4:40, and into Baltimore County and Cockeysville, possibly right after the top of the hour. Again, if you're in any of these neighborhoods and, of course, are going to be in the track of this storm, you want to actually seek shelter now and get to the lowest level of your house. In addition to this, we have that tornado threat, but we also have the wind and also the hail threat. Hail looks fairly minimal for now. However, the wind threat, we could see winds upwards of 55, 60 miles per hour with this same storm. Do you want to bring you an update on future cast as well? The strongest of the storms that we have been talking about all day long, in addition to this tornado warning, comes through most of the Baltimore metro around 5 o'clock, and it shifts eastward after that. So something we'll watch closely for the potential of severe weather ongoing through the early portions of this evening. Once again, we have that tornado watch that engulfs all areas shaded in yellow through about 9 o'clock this evening, and also the severe thunderstorm watch that extends through also 9 o'clock this evening for areas south and east of the city too. Nonetheless, it looks like we are looking at a severe threat ongoing over the next couple of hours. Again, a look at tornado safety. You want to get inside a sturdy home or building, lowest level of your house, away from windows, and also just seek shelter if you are in this track of the storm. I'm sending it back over to Tom to bring you the latest update on what's happening.
All right, Taylor, thank you very much. Yeah, this is a live picture from 97 and 140 up in Carroll County, where some wind is picking up there. We can definitely see that, some very heavy rain, a little bit of traffic there, and the torrential rains. It looks like that particular location, which would be 97 and 140, would be just north of the storm system up around here, with the possible tornado sitting down here, again, bearing down on that Glover Acres community there in Carroll County, just south of Westminster. So on the north side, you're getting a lot of heavy rain, but the I think the tornado threat is a little farther south of that, moving in this general location here, which would be, let's see, from, say, downtown Westminster, a couple miles just south of that is where the possible tornado is. And the BWI radar keeps picking up on these spikes of very high winds, so there's possibly a tornado sitting in here. 54 mile an hour winds picked up by the BWI radar on the last scan there, and that's why the National Weather Service has this warning going for that part of Carroll County until 4:30. Zoom in a little tighter and see that that warning encompasses Westminster, but the main threat is south of the city of Westminster and over toward Glover Acres, and probably along or just south of Route 40 there, over toward Reese, Sandyville. I think that would be the area that has the highest threat from a storm that's tracking in this general direction from the Glover Acres area over to Sandyville, and maybe eventually over toward Lawndale in the area near the Baltimore County line. So take shelter now. The warning goes until 4:30. There's going to be some heavy rain. There's going to be a lot of lightning. Could cause a quick flash flooding as it moves through. But right now, the main concern is that we could have a tornado embedded in this thunderstorm that's tracking across Carroll County and will quickly get into western Baltimore County. Notice there's also a cell south of that now that's showing up, and this one is showing some rotation as well. So we're in that situation where these cells that pop up may start to rotate and could produce isolated tornadoes. That's why a tornado watch is in effect. Watch out, meaning that their conditions are favorable for tornadoes to form in these sort of thunderstorms. So a number of rather discrete cells, the one here in Westminster where a warning is in effect, the one that's starting to show some rotation here in southern Carroll County, and now it looks like a new cell is in Montgomery County as well. These individual cells that develop like this tend to be the most vulnerable as far as tornadic activity goes, so most susceptible to having a tornado form. And so we're keeping a very close eye on it. Most of the area is under a tornado watch. That's that yellow shaded area here. These areas all have possible tornadic conditions. And then south, it's a severe thunderstorm where you'll have some strong storms, but not as likely to have a tornado. But our warning is for the one in Carroll County right now until 4:30, and we'll see if the Weather Service extends that warning over into Baltimore County if the storm holds together. Again, let's take a look at the wind velocity. That's the best way we have for tracking these storms, and you can see it's not looking quite as severe as it was just a few minutes ago. That's a good news. That's maybe a sign that it's weakening a bit, but the BWI radar is very distinct here. So there you see the very strong winds, 50, 60 mile an hour winds with a 94 mile an hour shear. That is this change in wind speed that is definitely apparent now with this cell that's just south of Westminster. So this looks pretty concerning. You definitely want to be taking shelter, getting out of the way of the storm if you can, or getting in the lowest level of your building. This is the area right here where we definitely have winds that are moving away from BWI's radar site and then moving down toward it, and some circulation is definitely indicated here by our radar. So very strong winds with this system, and the potential to produce some wind damage as it's making its way through. This is where we have the possibility of a tornado, so you don't want to take this lightly. You want to get away from it if you can, or you want to get in the lowest level of your building and away from this storm until the warning expires. Warning goes until 4:30. We've got Jen Franciotti. She's up in Carroll County right now. Jen, are you near this storm system, and what do you see?
Yeah, absolutely, Tom. And it's funny you said that it's just south of Westminster. So where we live, we have a Westminster address, a 21157 zip code. We're considered about 6 to 7 miles south of actual Westminster proper. Mm-hmm. And I can look north and I can see those dark clouds that you're talking about. And it's getting more energy, it looks like, as it's coming in from the west. And they're sort of meeting up to form now one big, giant, dark storm cloud. Start off with just a little tiny bit of wind. First, there was nothing once we got that first tornado warning. Then a little bit of wind, and now the wind is it's whipping around pretty good, and the rain is falling a little bit faster now. We've been hearing the thunder. I haven't seen any lightning yet associated with this, but it definitely is coming west and heading a little bit more north. So I'm sort of in a sweet spot where I see light sky behind me and nothing but dark clouds in front of me as you're looking in the north direction.
Okay, that's very good. I appreciate that, Jen. Hopefully you are in a safe location there, because it does look like we do have, you know, the potential here for a tornado in the Glover, is it Glover or Glover Acres neighborhood there, it looks like, around just north of Fenby and moving over toward 140 near Reese and Sandyville. It looks like the general direction of this storm in the last couple of minutes, it's been tracking rapidly east-southeast. The BWI radar has been picking up on some pretty strong wind shear, indicating the really distinct possibility we've got either a funnel cloud or a tornado touching down in that area near Glover Acres and tracking southeast towards Sandyville. Still, it looks like the storm would be west of Route 140 right now, but it's going to get over there near Route 40 pretty quickly and then head over toward Baltimore County as it makes its way toward Lawndale and maybe over into the western part of Baltimore County if it holds together. So that's our area of concern, as Jen mentioned, south of the city of Westminster in that part of Carroll County, right now on the west side of 140 near Glover Acres and tracking southeast. So take a precaution now. Latest little data from our BWI radar site, it looks a little better. Maybe it's weakening, but you don't want to let your guard down until this warning expires and until the storm passes by. Almost everybody who is in one of these systems or near them says you can definitely hear it. It's one of the ways you know when the threat is over is when the sound, that roaring sound that these storms make, passes you by. So right now it would be passing past Glover Acres and moving over towards Sandyville, and everybody in that general area should be taking shelter and being very cautious as far as the storm goes. There are other cells that we're watching. The Weather Service has now issued a warning for that cell in southern Carroll County, and northern Howard and western Baltimore County. Again, there are a number of discrete cells here that could produce tornadoes. The one has a warning associated with it with the really strong signature on radar up near Westminster or south of Westminster. But as you can see here on our radar scan, there are a number of cells like this one down here in southern Carroll County and one in Montgomery County that look pretty strong as well. So that's why the tornado watch is in effect, because we're going to see these things popping up from time to time over the next couple of hours. And as the atmosphere works its way through, they could start to spin and produce tornadoes. So that's what we've got going on right now. Right now, the watch covers most of central Maryland until tornado watch is in effect for our area throughout the evening hours, even onto the eastern shore until 9 p.m. And the severe thunderstorm watch, meaning conditions are favorable for strong storms, but probably not tornadoes, until 9 p.m. south of us into southern Maryland. Worst weather right now, though, is in Carroll County, again, just south of Westminster, where we've got a possible tornado happening in that location right now. And we've been tracking it with the radars that gives us all kinds of things. It shows where it's raining. It can show us the way the winds are moving. And the BWI radar site has been picking up on this little couplet here, which, again, is now moving very quickly, almost over to 140 now. This area right in here is our main concern. 89 mile an hour winds. Shear is the wind speed change in wind speed in a small area. 107 mile an hour wind shear, that's a lot. And that is a dangerous storm system that shows up in our area right about here. So to the south of Westminster, south of Reese, north of Walnut Groves, moving off to the east southeast at about 20 miles an hour. It's going to take it over toward Lawndale and eventually make its way over toward that Baltimore County line between Upper Coe and Reisterstown if it holds together. I'm just going to slide this back and forth so you see the motion in that area there where the red and the green and the yellows are coming together. That's our area of concern right in here right now, north of Walnut Grove, moving southeast at about 20 miles an hour. So the warning covers that entire area right on over toward the Baltimore County line. And again, it's possible this could be extended into Baltimore County if the storm holds together in that general area right there. So once again, worth going over our tornado safety tips, and it's kind of just common sense. Inside of a sturdy building, your home, hopefully into a basement on the lowest level if you don't have a basement. Inside the interior of the building seems to be the safest, a room or a hallway, a bathroom that's in the interior in those locations. Cover your head, get away from windows, let the sound of the storm pass on by. Taylor, have you seen anything else on chat yet?
Nothing quite yet, except for they are continuing the tornado warning in effect in Carroll County. Again, it's ongoing until around 4:30. We'll see again if they will actually extend that. I think it's likely that they do. Again, I don't make the call. In addition to that, I'm really surprised that we haven't seen another tornado warning issued for the storm just south of there. So I do want to give you a wider view of exactly what is happening right now. This entire area is exactly what we have been talking about all day and are very concerned about as we move forward. Again, we have a couple areas of actual rotation popping up here. Again, the first and foremost is where we had that tornado warning, and this is exactly where we anticipate it's going to be heading. It's moving south and east slightly at around 25 miles per hour, so certainly moving pretty fast. Here are the towns and neighborhoods it will be near Reisterstown around 4:44, Cockeysville after the top of the hour, possibly even Towson and Baltimore County around 5:20 if this storm does hold together. A little bit south of there, this is another concerning storm. We are at least anticipating that it's moving east at around 25 miles per hour and out. There is not exactly a tornado warning effect, but there is some rotation showing up on radar with this storm system. Outside of that, we also have severe winds coming in with it, upwards of 60 miles per hour, and even the potential of some small sized hail as well. So again, tracking this out for you, here are the neighborhoods it could be located near: Randallstown around 4:50, Pikesville after the top of the hour, and Lutherville around 5:16. Again, here's that other storm that we are continuing to watch, kind of showing rotation here on velocity. So we'll watch this closely as it moves eastward, possibly into Baltimore County here shortly. Again, I do want to remind you that we have a tornado watch that engulfs all the areas shaded in yellow through 9 o'clock this evening, and a severe thunderstorm watch that is ongoing through 9 o'clock as well for areas south and west of the city. Again, that goes into effect all the way through 9 o'clock this evening. Again, as Tom just mentioned, here are some safety tips. If you are at any point in time today under a tornado warning, get inside a sturdy building, lowest level of your house, and away from windows. And of course, we're going to continue to keep you updated on the tornado warnings happening across the area today. Right now, we just have that one that is ongoing over the next couple of minutes, and we'll see if it actually gets extended for Baltimore County here shortly. For now, we're going to send it back over to Tom with the latest update.
All right, Taylor, and maybe social media is getting some reports or not. I don't know. We can check that. We'll see if anybody up there in Carroll County, once the storm has passed by, if you have any reports that you can safely send us, we definitely appreciate that. On our Twitter account, you can get Taylor, Grenda, or me at T-Tassel, WBAL. Send us something on Twitter if you can. But again, don't want you to do that while the storm is moving through. Wait for the sound of the storm to pass by when it's a little safer to do that. This warning is set to expire at 4:30, so we will see if it goes off of our map here in that time frame. That's when the National Weather Service will make the decision whether or not to extend it. We can say that right now it looks like it's a little bit in weaker, but we still see a bit of that wind shear where we have red and green on this particular map coming together. It's an indication of winds that are blowing away from a radar site down at the airport or toward it in the green, and so that does show some rotation with this storm. Doesn't necessarily mean there is a tornado there, but it says that there is some rotation with this thunderstorm that's making its way through. And for a while this afternoon, as we've been covering this particular storm, that rotation has been very distinct and very strong. So the potential that at least there was briefly a tornado, maybe a funnel cloud that briefly touched down or stayed on the ground, we'll just have to wait and see if we get any kind of reports of damage from it. But this is the area in red that is under the warning. And when a tornado warning is issued, you know that there is a very distinct possibility of a tornado in that area. The prime concern in this area here is pretty much in the southern part of this red shaded area from Glover Acres down to Walnut Grove in this sort of particular location and heading eventually down toward the Baltimore County line toward Woodensburg or Reisterstown in this area. It looks like if it holds together, that would be it, the main spot that would be impacted by this storm. As Taylor was mentioning, there are other cells that are of concern. The one in southern Carroll County has been warned for damaging winds and hail possible with that one. And also in Montgomery County, a separate cell. So you kind of see the distinct cells here that develop in this sort of a pattern, one up to the north, one there, and then one down to the south. And these three all are very strong thunderstorms. But the one that has the most significant threat is the one that has the possible tornado up in Carroll County with a warning that goes for another couple of minutes. So on the BWI radar, again, before we were seeing very strong winds, very strong wind shear, not quite as distinct right now, but still something showing up in this general area of Walnut Grove moving southeast. So folks in Baltimore County should be getting ready to take shelter. Even if the tornado warning is dropped, a very strong thunderstorm is going to be coming into western Baltimore County. And so you would definitely want to be taking precautions in case the tornado returns or in case just damaging winds from the actual severe thunderstorm reach your area. So this is this area of concern here near Walnut Grove, tracking southeast, just south of 140. Over toward the Reisterstown area. We'll see if it gets into western Baltimore County in the next couple of minutes. Again, that's only a few miles, and with the storm that's moving at 20 to 25 miles an hour, it's going to cover 5 miles in a quarter of an hour. You know, it's going to get there in just 15 minutes or so, 10, 15 minutes. This strong cell will be passing through the Reisterstown area. So even if we see that the tornado warning is dropped, be very careful there in the Reisterstown area of western Baltimore County. Regardless, a very strong thunderstorm is moving in your direction and will likely move in the next few minutes. So the entire region is under a watch, meaning conditions are favorable until 9 p.m. Taylor, yes?
It's expired.
It has expired, so let's go back to our warning here. And there you see, as Taylor mentioned, the red has been taken off the map. It is now a strong thunderstorm. Be careful, but the tornado warning has expired. If another warning is issued, we'll come back. And of course, we'll have a complete report coming up on 11 News at 5 o'clock. We'll get you right back to the Olympics now.